Haas. Athletic Center at the campus of Wheaton College in Norton, Massachusetts. This is our 2018 Wheaton College Commencement. I am Peter J. Wiggins. It is a Saturday, May 19th, 2018, and we're at Wheaton College Commencement, the 183rd Commencement. And we are indoors instead at the temple because of the upcoming rainy weather I witnessed on the radar. And there is a lot and lots and lots and lots of people attending the Wheaton Commencement on this Saturday afternoon, that is Saturday morning. And we got the Boston Brass Ensemble over there performing a piece. And we got a lot of crowds in attendance. Today's guest speaker will be Senator George Mitchell. Everybody filing into their seats. As commencement will get underway in a few minutes, come down. Two Wheaton College Public Safety Officers. You knew?
Right.
Yes, it's her.
Johnny.
Thank you. been, Ollie?
Good, how are you doing?
Doing good today, Ollie. Emily.
Yeah, Emily's coming.
Hey, Ollie, doing good today, Ollie.
Oppie's right
there. Emily, Oppie, I'm an Oppie. And Ollie. Ollie, yep, that's right. Go Lions! That's right. Friend Robert Seamus was there for that graduation. And there you see the staff.
Suzanne.
College. How you feeling? How you all feeling? Feeling good? That's right. I wish you luck in your future endeavors. Now they got pomp and circumstance.
Thank you. conferring of degrees. May this indeed be a memorable occasion for everyone. Rabbi and Professor of Religion, Jonathan Rumberg Krauss, will now offer the invocation. Please rise and remain standing after the invocation for the singing of the Wheaton hymn. Enjoy.
Welcome, graduates, family, friends, alumni, staff, and faculty. Let me begin with some lines written by graduating senior religion major and poet Kaylee Brogan. Thinking about graduation, she asked me through the wreckage of my own imagination, getting anxious about big life transitions. I'm not anxious, I'm dying. Rites of passage, like graduation, are fraught crossings of boundaries from one space-time to another. Thus, in my Jewish tradition, we recite the special separation prayer, Havdalah, to mark the end of the Sabbath and the start of a festival, like for Shavuot, the time for the gift of our Torah, that is, teaching, that happens tonight and celebrates our sacred ambivalence about boundaries. And so, blessed are you, Spirit of the world, who separates between holy and ordinary, between our fear of the unknown ahead of us and our comfort in what we have come to know, between light and dark, to respect the differences between black and white and all the shades that make up the vibrant rainbow of our community, to know not to trespass over them and to know when to bridge them, between the seventh day of rest and the 6 days of work, because all work and no rest or play harms our bodies and souls. You separate between Sabbath holiness and the holiness of festivals, Ramadan and Kippur, because there are many kinds of times and things that elevate us, of which we're acutely aware today. You make us holy through your holiness, and we are elevated through our relationships with the world, family, friends, teachers, companions, neighbors, significant human and other than human persons with whom we're celebrating today. Blessed are you, Spirit of the world, who separates and teaches us to distinguish between different kinds of holiness. Ben Kodesh LeKodesh. So let's rejoice, first in Hebrew and then in an English version inspired by the words of my teacher, mentor, and friend, Maureen Parnell. Baruch Atah Adonai. Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, Shehechiyanu, V'Kiyamanu, V'Higiyanu, Lazman HaZeh. Our praise to you, Spirit of good endings and better beginnings, of homecomings and of life launchings, whose name is also wisdom, for giving us life, sustaining us, and enabling us to reach this time. Amen.
Thank you, JBK. Now let me call on Shi Cho Yong to lead us in the singing of the Wheaton hymn. Then they knew it.
constant rain, anger not seen. Hey, when I saw a boy says new, seen of all her ears to me, infernals when
back in the days when it was a women's college.
Altogether, there are 500 alumni on campus. You hail from 30 states and a number of countries, from the United Kingdom and Estonia to Hong Kong. Your many accomplishments in the world exemplify the breadth and talent of the Wheaton community. To Wheaton's amazing faculty, your energy, enthusiasm, and expertise make all the difference for our students. Thank you. Let's hear it for them. Wheaton's ability to offer a great liberal arts education begins with you, dedicated teachers and renowned scholars, scientists, performers, and artists. I want to especially thank four professors who are also graduating this year after distinguished teaching careers. John Kreitzer, professor of biology. Alita Pastor Landis, professor of chemistry. William McPherson, assistant professor of music and college organist. Guy Urban, associate professor of music. If any of the four of you have not left and retired already, please stand and be recognized. Significant milestones this year. First of all, Barbara Darling, assistant professor of religion, who was honored with the Faculty Appreciation Award by the senior class. Congratulations and well deserved. Barbara. Ali Reza Shamali, associate professor of political science. Who has been appointed to hold the Jane E. Ruby Chair in Humanities and Social Sciences. Michael Berg, Nancy Evans, and Gabriela Torres. Each of whom has been appointed and promoted to full professor. Congratulations to all of you. To Wheaton staff, your contribution to our students' education are many and varied, from the advice and support you offer students to the myriad tasks you perform to maintain this campus as a vibrant learning community. Thank you to our staff. To the class of 2018, soon you will walk across the stage, diploma in hand, ready for new adventures. You will take with you all the knowledge and the skills and the perspective that you have earned in the past 4 years, from studio art and history and business to biology, psychology and economics, from all of the different areas we focus on here. And you are headed to exciting new places, outstanding jobs, top graduate schools, public service, and world travel. I know you will do great things just It's been my privilege and pleasure to watch you in action, proving campus life in so many ways. Along those lines, I want to take a moment to acknowledge how generous you have been with your time and with your philanthropy. More than half of your class has contributed to the senior class gift. Thanks for that, and especially to senior class gift co-chairs, Ariel Klopsis and Henry Lewis, right here in the front, who have led the way. Today, class of 2018, your families and friends, join us in celebrating all that you have achieved, as well as all that you can and will do in the future. Bravo. Congratulations. It's now my great privilege and pleasure to introduce your student speaker today, the president of the class of 2018. You know him as AK, AKA But for those of you who are just meeting him for the first time, it's my pleasure to call on President of the Senior Class, Akrofi Akotia, for his greetings.
Woo! Vice President, and on to the next adventure. Thank you.
GBH.
Under the radar with Cali Crosby, and a weekly commentator on the radio station's morning edition. As a regular panelist on WGBH television's Meet the Press, as a frequent host of this long-standing, long-running program, Basic Black, and as a regular guest of Fox 25 Boston's morning show. Naturally, nationally, you contribute to programs on CNN, PBS, and other networks. For all of these accomplishments, for the stories you tell and continue to share, for the ways you promote better, more inclusive journalism, and for being a mentor and inspiration to the next generation of journalists, Cali Crosby would present you with this honorary Doctor of Humane Letters.
By the authority vested in me by the trustees and the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, I hereby confer upon you the honorary degree, Doctor of Humane Letters, and admit you to all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Welcome to Wheaton.
John Crosley, senior on Beat the Press on WGBH, and also she's been with GBH since the days.
Thank you.
Thank you. I am delighted to receive this great honor from Wheaton College. I feel right at home in a place which celebrates a liberal arts education and whose history is rooted in the education of women. And were my parents here to see it, they would get a kick out of finding out that I'm being honored for talking. I don't know how many times they sighed as they heard from my elementary school teachers, Callie is friendly and courteous, but she talks a lot. I must have asked thousands of questions in my career as a broadcast journalist, and I'm always searching for the one that will open up the story from the interviewee. And a few years ago, I was interviewing a group of highly credentialed women who were in public service, and I asked them for the one thing that they could remember that without their specific intervention, it would not have happened. And they thought, and each of them, now remember these are big time women with many, many accomplishments, went back to the early days of their career and a small hands-on action that made a victory possible. And it reminds me always that we should not dismiss the early days of what we do to get our voices out there and of our contribution, and that we each have a unique contribution to make that with only our contribution can make some things happen. So college is the place to find your voice, to figure out who you are and who you are in the world. But I've come to realize that finding your voice is not the same as using your voice. Using your talents for something bigger than yourself in service to your family, to your community, to your nation. Those of you who've had the privilege of this fine education have been trained to take up leadership roles. How will you use your voice? When the whole world is silent, even one voice becomes powerful, says Pakistani activist Malala Yousafzai, the young woman who was shot in the head by the Taliban because she dared to advocate for girls' education. Today, she is the youngest Nobel Prize winner, is studying at Oxford, and what's more important, more girls are getting an education because of her singular efforts. Obviously, she's one in a million, a global phenomenon on a world stage, but there is plenty of room for each of us to make a mark. I have chosen to tell the stories of the ones who can't speak for themselves. These stories have broadened the perspectives of people who don't know or don't know any better, simply because of their lack of exposure. And I have chosen to be the one in the room willing to tell the uncomfortable truth out loud. There are any number of extremely talented broadcast journalists who are my contemporaries, but when I do my work, I remind myself that nobody can offer my perspective the way that I can, and nobody else has your voice either. I can't wait to hear what you have to say out in the world. Thank you so much for this honor, and congratulations, class.
Trustee Cheryl Badeau, class of 74, will now present Rose Ella Weaver, class of 73, for the honorary degree, Doctor of Fine Arts. Thank you.
jazz vocalist and in your work as an educator. The art that you make illuminates the human experience in ways that honor the dignity of each individual. And we are enriched by your artistry, your compassion, and your insight. It is our great honor to present you, Rose Weaver, with this honorary Doctor of Fine Arts.
I am the awarding designee by the trustees of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. I hereby confer upon you the honorary degree, Doctor of Fine Arts, and admit you to all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Welcome to Wheaton, Part 2.
It turns out I wasn't afraid of swimming after all. I
was afraid of sinking and drowning. With so many odds already against me, I was afraid of sinking and drowning. Every time you get that sinking feeling, just realize that what you really need to do is learn how to stay afloat so you can swim unafraid with yourself, with yourselves, and with all kinds of people in win-win ways. You got that? You got it?
Got it.
Okay, then. See you in the pool.
We are so glad you passed the swimming test. This is an infrequent occurrence, but I would like to give a student the honor of introducing our next honorary degree recipient. I would like to call upon Class of 2018 member Tyler Butler to present Senator George Mitchell for the honorary degree of Doctor of Laws. Tyler.
When the national conversation is fraught with conflict and the political divide seems uncrossable, being able to listen well with patience and humility is invaluable. You, George Mitchell, have built a successful career on the values serving your country and citizens around the globe by listening to people speak and helping create solutions. We recognize you today for that service, and for the lesson we can learn from your experiences. After earning a bachelor's degree from Wheaton College in your home state of Maine, followed by a law degree from Georgetown University, you worked as a trial lawyer, federal judge, and executive assistant to U.S. Senator Edmund Muskie, whose seat you later filled, first by appointment, then by election. You served 15 years in the Senate, where you have said you developed these keen listening skills, including 6 years as majority leader, and you were instrumental in the passage of several pieces of landmark legislation. Your reputation as an artful negotiator has earned you a seat in historic talks aimed at finding common ground amid conflict, first in Northern Ireland, and then in the Middle East. You've been called upon again and again because of your aptitude for thoughtfulness, honest investigation, and deliberation. In addition, for your many years of public service, you've served in leadership roles with a variety of businesses and organizations. For your impressive career in public service, law, and business, and for your skill at making people feel heard and offering balanced insight, George Mitchell, we present you with this honorary Doctor's of Law.
By the authority vested in me by the trustees of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, I hereby confer upon you the honorary degree, Doctor of Laws, and admit you to all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations.
This is a great speak so often that for me, frankly, the highlight of the day is the introduction. I want to thank Tyler for that wonderful introduction. It's always a pleasure to hear nice things said about yourself, especially from the large group, mostly strangers. The risk, of course, is if you hear that stuff too often, you might begin to believe it. And that's dangerous for your mental health. So I'd like to begin with a story about introductions and an occasion of which I was brought back down to earth. I spent 5 years working on the peace process in Northern Ireland, and when my work was complete, I returned to my home and made a book about my experience. When it was published, I traveled the country on a book promotion tour. I received a very large number of invitations, and in that process, I learned the interesting fact that in the United States, there are more Irish American organizations than there are Irish Americans. But I did go to many of these. I traveled the country speaking to these groups of Irish Americans. They developed among them an informal competition to give the longest, most fantastic, often truly ridiculous introductions of them. The proper reaction, of course, would have been for me to show some humility, ask them to keep it short. But I had an improper reaction. I loved it. I encouraged it. I scolded them when they left something out. And so by the time I got to the last stop on this book tour, it was in Stamford, Connecticut. I was overly impressed with myself. As I entered the building where the event was being held that evening, the first person I encountered was an elderly woman who rushed up to me, very nervous and excited, shook my hand vigorously. Spent several minutes praising me. Then she said, I don't live anywhere near here. I drove 3 hours across the entire state of Connecticut just to come here and tell you how much I admire you and ask you, please, would you autograph my poster? She had a poster with a big photograph on it. She handed it to me with a pen. I looked at it. I said, I'm very happy to sign your poster. Before I knew, I think there's something I must tell you. She said, what is it? I said, I'm not Henry Kissinger. It was a picture of Kissinger. I said, you're not, who are you anyway? She said, why, that's just terrible. She said, I drove 3 hours to meet a great man, and all I've got is a nobody like you. I said, I'm sorry you feel so bad. I wish there's something I could do to make you feel better. And after a moment, she said, well, there is. And she said, nobody will ever know the difference. I'm still hanging today in the living room wall in Eastern Connecticut, a daily reminder to me not to take too seriously all of these nice stories. Well, let me speak seriously about you, our country, in your future. More than 2 centuries ago, our founding fathers created a revolution on the soil of North America and in the world of ideas. They took the best of government itself, and opportunity for every member of our society. Neither we nor anyone else should ever forget that the United States was a great nation long before it was a great military power or economic power. We recognize that all human beings and all human societies are imperfect. We are not always right, and we can never be perfectly consistent. Yet we can and must work harder and better to live up to our principles as individuals and as a nation. We're fortunate to be Americans, to live in a society which, despite our many and serious imperfections, is still, to me, the most free, the most just, the most open in all of human history. From that society, each of us receives many benefits. With benefits come responsibilities. You graduates have the good fortune to receive an advanced education at a highly rated institution of higher education. You have an important role to play in preserving and improving our way of life. There's much for all of us to do. Each of you will have your own list of what you see as our society's challenges and of its failures. I'll mention just two that have been important to me throughout my public career. If you believe that every American child, regardless of background or family wealth, is entitled to a good education, you must oppose any action that would prevent them having that opportunity. If you believe that every American is entitled to equal opportunity and equal justice, you must stand up and speak out against all forms of discrimination and injustice. Never forget that in the presence of evil, silence makes you an accomplice. Power vested in me under our Constitution and law.
Senator George Mitchell, certainly you inspire me and I'm sure all of us. Just a side note, as I think about our three honorary degree recipients today and the breadth of things that they have achieved in their lives, you should have no doubt about the power of a liberal arts degree. Wellesley, Bowdoin, and Wheaton, and look at all they have achieved. We're proud to recognize you, and especially to our Wellesley and Bowdoin honorary degree recipients. We hope this degree gives you a chance at some success finally. So this is your time, but just a few things before that. So first of all, Becca Rosenthal, where's Becca? Where's Becca? Stand up, Becca, where are you? It's a good occasion for a birthday party, isn't it? Happy birthday, Becca.
Happy birthday, Becca!
And another quick shout out, Chanel. Chanel, you're frozen. Where's Chanel? Chanel's family from Burundi could not be here because they don't have the freedom that we just talked about. And if they watch this, I want them to know that your family is with you right here, Chanel. This is your Wheaton family. Walking across the stage, but before we do that, I'd like to take just a few minutes to reflect with you. Reflect with me on all that has happened in your lives since the last time that many of us in this room gathered in this very same place. Do you remember? August of 2014, you arrived on campus to begin your studies in Wheaton, and we held your welcoming ceremony in the same place. The weather gods made sure that you were back here. You were the first class that I had the pleasure of welcoming to Wheaton, and you've been the best. I looked back at a photo from that day, because you may remember I took a selfie up here. I won't embarrass you to do that again. But looking at those faces, many that I see out there right now, you looked pretty nervous. And so was I, quite honestly. I had no idea what journey was about to begin for me, and I'm guessing that many of you felt that same way. But what an amazing 4 years it's been. What makes any journey become so special is the discoveries you make along the way. Think of the discoveries you've made along this journey. For example, think back to your first winter here. We discovered together that there actually is such a thing as too many snow days. Because by the end of February, you were coming to me asking me not to cancel any more classes. I've never heard.
Wow.
And this year, who knew you could survive 48 hours without electricity? And as many of you in the hunt to charge your phones, discovered power outlets in the library that none of us even knew were there.
Yep, I survived that.
And I know just about all of you have had to discover new ways to make sure that the Norton water doesn't turn the whites in your laundry brown. At least I know I've had to struggle with that. And if you figured it out, let me know, okay? But I know that you have had many other wonderful discoveries beyond these during your time here at Wheaton. I've seen what you've been able to do in the classroom with your artistic and performing talents and initiatives through your leadership of so many campus programs and initiatives through your athletic abilities. I've seen how you've grown, how you've changed, and most importantly, how you have changed Wheaton College. What I've discovered by working with you over the last 4 years is that you can achieve just about anything you set your mind to. Don't ever lose that tenacity and that focus. As you reflect, I hope you also realize that the discoveries you've made are so much sweeter and so much more rewarding because you did them together with some really, really special people. When you sat in this room 4 years ago, I'll bet you couldn't even imagine the friendships you would form and the ways that the other people in this room, everybody, the strangers you had just met, would become such a big part of your life. I can say that this was definitely true for me, but now I can tell you I will have so many fond memories of the journey we've had together over the last 4 years. Let me just share a few with you before you walk across the stage. Traveling with so many of you, so many I can't name them all, to both Ghana and Rwanda over the last 4 years has led to so many adventures and so many discoveries. For example, I never would have imagined that my roomie in Ghana, Josh LeBlanc, would actually snore louder than me. Nor that Kate McLaughlin would become my best friend for life after she traveled with me way back in her first year. Having dinner on my back porch with Omar and Mike Sadowski over the summer after their first year, and thinking these guys have big plans, and thinking they'll never do it. And then watching them over the last 3 years achieve their goals and so much more. Being amazed at how Charlotte Middleton can use her artistic talent to tell powerful and very personal stories that move us all. Legend, live on at Wheaton long after you leave campus. You have left your mark. Having my days brightened so many times by that smile and not to mention that voice of James Wagner. Has anyone ever seen him without a smile on his face? I never have.
Ooh.
And speaking of uplifting, has anyone ever not had fun when Connor Mathis is around? He lights up the room with his presence, his wit, his talent, and his infectious enthusiasm. And while we're talking about energy, enthusiasm, and being uplifting, Khadija.
Yeah!
Need I say more? Khadija. Realizing that only at Wheaton could you find someone who majors in both creative writing and literature and philosophy while captaining the rugby team, getting a few concussions and things along the way, serving as editor of The Wire, and then who then earns a Watson Fellowship to study the meaning and culture of mixed martial arts in different places around the world. There's only one Lucas Rosa, and we are very proud. Thinking at first, when I met him, that Javon Ferguson didn't like me because he never had very much to say, but then discovering that Javon never has much to say, but that when he does, it speaks truth and is deep and powerful. Thank you, Javon. Sparring with Raven Fontaine. Just because she's so competitive and it's so much fun to see her get all worked up. So easy to pick on. Thanks, Raven, for representing us so well on the track, right here. Over your 4 years here, we will all be rooting for you to add another All-American medal to your bling at the Outdoor Nationals. Yeah, go do it, Raven. Watching so many of you shape the campus by pursuing important issues and personal passions. For example, watching Hannah Zack do raise awareness around accessibility on campus has truly been inspiring. Similarly, the countless hours that Rachel Barbarisi has spent on building an amazing Best Buds program. Thank you, Rachel. Had a big impact on so many people on and off campus, including me. Seeing people like Nina Kenny Yes, after those 7 emails you sent me, I will give you a shout out. Nina Kenny, giving so much to our community, to members of the community, by seemingly being at every single event with that camera around her neck. Nina, your skills are amazing. And for those of you in the audience, anyone looking to hire a great photographer, I'm her agent. Come see me. But also, Nina, I will miss all my Twitter exchanges with your mother, Lisa. I hope we keep corresponding that way. Oh, and speaking of mothers, Susan Fallon. Susan Fallon must be out there somewhere. I don't know what I'm going to do if you don't call my office every week with some new idea or something. Pam in my office will really miss you. So, you know, keep calling if you want. So, and we'll change the number. Talking about lives, careers, challenges, the future, and so many other topics with so many of you, but probably none more than Zelda Zao. Yeah, Zelda. I'm honored that all of you, particularly you, Zelda, asked me for advice and counsel so many times, and I'm looking forward to many, many more conversations in the future. And finally, thinking about how disappointed I was when I said to Stephen Kimball, as he was transferring at the end of his first year, there will always be a place for you at Wheaton. Stay in touch. And then how excited I was when he emailed me less than 2 months after that and said, whoops, I made a mistake. Can I come back? Stephen, I'm thrilled to see you walk across the stage, and I think of how much better Wheaton is because we left the door open and you came back. Don't any of you ever forget, the door is always open. Just like Stephen, you're about to leave, but this time it's going to be slightly different. All of you, including Stephen, will be taking with you a piece of paper that provides evidence of all you have achieved here. I hope that piece of paper will also serve as a reminder to you of all you have discovered during your time here and the many, many people who have been part of your journey. You have been a part of my entire Wheaton experience, and it has been an amazing 4 years for me. You have brought so much energy and light to this campus. And today, you leave us for a world that now, more than ever, needs your energy and light. Go brighten the world like you have brightened this campus. You have brought us, you have brought me much joy. Thank you. Now for the moment which you have all been waiting for, we will move now to the conferring of earned degrees. Provost Renee White will present the candidates.
Will all the members of the class of 2018 please rise? Members of the class of 2018 who have fulfilled to the satisfaction of the faculty all the requirements for the degree of Bachelor of Arts.
By the authority vested in me by the trustees in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, I confer upon each of you the degree of Bachelor of Arts and declare you to be entitled to all the rights, privileges and honors pertaining to that degree. In testimony thereof, and as evidence that you have fulfilled all the requirements, the trustees grant you the Diploma of Wheaton College. Please be seated. Congratulations. Now comes the fun part. Dean of Students, Kate McCaffrey, will now present the graduates. I'll meet you up here.
On the baseball team.
Area Lee Klapsis, class gift co-chair, Magna Cum Laude. Henry Cable Lewis, class gift co-chair.
Henry!
The Student Government Association Executive Board members of the class of 2018. Mary Yvonne Sasso, president.
Mary!
Maya June Benson, vice president. Silva Jones, Programming Council Chair. Lindsay Beth Jackier, Education Council Chair, summa cum laude. Daniela Pena, Alumni Association Chair, cum laude. Syed Osama Ali Zaidi, Hearing Board Chair.
Thank you.
Abby!
Aliza Danielle Epstein.
James Holston, cum James Chester Horn. Gabriella Ruth Halsey, summa cum laude. Sean James Herlberg.
Yes, Sean!
Quinn Elizabeth Hurst, cum laude. Rachel Renee Ayubola, magna cum laude.
Yeah, Rachel!
Chanel Aracosi.
What up?
Mackenzie Richard Irving. Julie Ann Janeskis, cum laude. Kelly, James George McFadder, Jordan Davis McKay.
Woohoo! Jordy!
Ryan Jackson McKeon, cum laude.
Ryan!
Catherine McLaughlin.
Member of the girls' basketball team, go Lions!
Erin Quinn Moynihan. Keegan Carr Murphy, cum laude. Jalen Juwan.
Obey! Obey!
Andrea Rojas Medina.
Francis.
Dimitri Rumiliatos.
Yes.
Dimitri.
Derek Ruin.
Yeah, Jimmy. Mr. Waco, Mr. Waco. Our number one fan,
Sandra.
Jimmy. Thank Mr. Waco, Mr. Waco. Yep. There's number one.
Yes. Rachel, Elizabeth Savage, magna cum laude. Yes. Thomas James Shivani, cum laude. Andrew Gardner Schofield, magna cum laude. John Thomas Siegel, magna cum laude. Amara. Yushen Wang, magna cum laude.
World Series.
World Series.
As a senior,
you weren't able to be here
commencement. Perhaps you experienced me walking backwards around campus as an admissions guy, or you spent a summer here doing research for a professor. Maybe you were a Fulbright, Watson, Balfour scholar who traveled the world with your academic skills and your toolkit. And over a period of over 40 plus years, many of us have shared a classroom with Tim Barker, Alex Bloom, Beverly Clark, Sam Cole, Andy Howard, John Kreischer, and our very own alum, Alita Pastolanis, class of 69. Or
across Peacock Pond after an early morning run. You see, whether you graduated in 73 or 2003, we are all part of Wheaton's history. Today, you saw the legacy of classes who walk before you. And they walk through the path that you created. And then, as is fitting, you follow behind them, the newest members of a long and elegant story.
All right.
them ring with rainbow gladness sing, joining with other far and near, if only here to celebrate a gifting day. I found her with her vision ring. We sing to soar and skip orbits that we know, seeing above the horizon stand a woman beyond their kin. They strove for freedom from the mind. We hear the stories strong and few, great and plain and new. Too many toils, the dreams we see, a full world wide to us they gave. We sing their praises, and we too abundantly. Within our founders, vision rare, risking the storm while charting our new view. As men and women, we'll give unique of the world.
Thank you.
I quit. Hey, Chris. These are the graduates of the 2018 Wheaton College Commencement. They got their roses and their diplomas after 4 years of hard work, and now it is on to the real world, where they're going to live, achieve, live their goals, live their dreams to the fullest. So congratulations to all the 2018 Wheaton College graduates from the Honorary Mayor of Naughton, Peter J. Wiggins, and also my friend, Robert Stevens. Congrats to all the graduates. Because I cover Wheaton sports on the Peter Channel. Woo! Riding in the sunset of Wheaton College in Norton, Massachusetts. Oh, these graduates have shown boys as they got their diplomas. Yeah, Dimitri! Woo! Dimitri! Woo! Dimitri! Dimitri!
Are we going after Theo?
Thank you.
And that concludes the 2018 Wheaton College Commencement. On this Saturday, May 19th, 2018, this is Peter J. Wiggins, and I hope you have a good day, and go on!